Good morning to everyone. My name is Aldo La Plaga and I am a PhD student at the University of Parma. In this presentation, I'm going to show you an analysis of a monitoring system to evaluate the gap value in bond insulated joints. Bond insulated joint is a railway component necessary for the correct separation of track circuits. In addition to the physical discontinuity created by the two adjacent rail sections, it must also provide proper electrical insulation. The degradation and failure of a rail joint is a serious maintenance problem on railway line. We can see some typical problems. In figure A, we can see the separation between the joint bar and the rail. In figure B, we can see sliding wear on the rail edge. Finally, in figure C, we can see a more severe case of joint bar failure. Therefore, the objective of this study was to analyze a monitoring system capable of anticipating any problems typical of this element. The monitoring system designed allows remote, continuous, and real-time measurement of the formations affecting bond insulated joints. Continuous monitoring make it possible to respond at an early level and prevent critical events that could impact rail traffic. The monitoring system analyzed includes the application of a fiber optic strain gauge with a Bragg grating in the adjacent rail edge. The quantity returned is the variation of the gap, expressed in millimeters. Figure A shows the correct location according to the Italian national requirements, while Figure B shows the monitoring device installed in the field. The first phase of our study focused on validating the quantity measured by the monitoring system using an analytical model. Specifically, the analytical model studied was the Zimmermann model, based on Winkler's theory. The vertical pressure Px between the joint bars and the rail can be expressed with the first equation shown on the left, where Wr1 is the vertical deflections of the rail 1 and Wb is the vertical deflections of joint bar as it transits the load, and Kb is the vertical stiffness coefficient of the epoxy resin used to bond the joint. The analytical model is outlined in figure. The origin of x-axis is positioned in the center to exploit the symmetry of the configuration. In addition, regions 1 and 2 are distinguished to highlight the presence or lack of the joint bar. Equation turns into the differential equations in which, in addition to the already described parameters, Wr2 is the vertical deflection of the rail 2 and K0 is the elastic modulus of the assembly consisting of sleepers, ballast and subgrade. Using the characteristic parameters of the rail and the joint and considering the load given by the configuration of the Stadler flat train used on the line under investigation, it was possible to solve the system of differential equations. The parameter of interest to us was the rotation phi, obtained from the first derivative of the vertical deflection of the rail. The rotation phi, when multiplied by the distance between the neutral axis of the rail and the line of application of the sensor, allows us to obtain the value of the gap delta L. The results obtained from the application of the analytical model were adequate for the predicted displacement, so it was possible to proceed to the next step of the study. In the second phase of our study, we focused on finite element simulation of the joint using Abacus software. The joint was modeled according to the geometric specifications of the Italian operator by examining two sections of rail, each long 30 cm. In addition to the rails, were modeled the joint bars, bolts with nuts, and insulation materials. The resin used to bond the joint was included in the model using cohesive behavior. The focus of the analysis was to evaluate the interaction between the bolts and the holes in the rail. Then post wasn't included in the model because it doesn't contribute to the mechanical interaction investigated. We choose to fix one rail and apply a 0.0 meter displacement to the other rail in accordance with the analytical model, as shown in the figure on the left. Were considered four cases by simulating the progression of the epoxy debonding identified as the typical failure condition. To do this, the interaction surfaces between the joint bar and the rail were divided into four, as shown in the figure on the right, denoted by the number 1, 2, 3 and 4. The cases studied were case A, which simulates the fully bonded joint, case B, which simulates the fully unbonded joint, case C, which considers one rail debonded from the joint bar and one rail bonded, case D, where only one of the four contact surfaces is debonded. Keeping the imposed displacement unchanged, were evaluated the strain variation induced by the change in the bonding properties between the joint bar and the rails. We look at the strain values in the axial direction. In the left figure, we look at the joint as a whole. In the figure on the right, we have drawn attention to the holes in the rail. It is possible to compare the stresses between the case where the joint is fully bonded, case A, and the cases where separation is simulated. We can see that, for the same displacement, the cases in which the bonding of the joint bar has been simulated show an amplification of the strain. In particular, if we look in detail what happens to the holes in the rail in case B compared to case A, we have high strains highlighted in orange. This means that the bolts are more in contact with the holes in the rail, possibly causing the holes ovalizations. In extreme cases, this can lead to very dangerous cracks, as they are covered by the joint bar and are therefore not visually identifiable. Considering only the gap value, this may not be immediately detected by the monitoring device in question. In this study was evaluated the use of sensors monitoring the longitudinal displacement of the rails at the joint. The application of Zimmermann's analytical model validated the quantities obtained from monitoring systems under investigation. After the validation of the record data, a finite element analysis was carried out by simulating the detachment of the epoxy resin and observing the axial deformation directly correlated to the measurements recorded by monitoring system. These simulations show how these devices fail to capture all aspects of the deterioration of this railway joint, but they provide useful support for maintenance operations. This work represents a first step in the development of a tailored monitoring system useful for obtaining data to calibrate appropriate forecasting models, to predict the degradation phenomena and to support maintenance activities aimed at damage progression. Thank you for your attention.